60th anniversary of Workers' Party of Korea celebrated in presence of Kim Jong-il. The glorious Workers' Party of Korea is the organizer and guide of all victories of the Korean people. Sixty years have elapsed since President Kim Il-sung, the eternal leader of the Korean people, founded the Workers' Party of Korea on October 10, 1945. On the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea, mosaic murals were done and inaugurated in many units. The murals carry the august images of President Kim Il-sung, the founder of the Workers' Party of Korea, and leader Kim Jong-il, the great successor to the cause of the party. President Kim Il-sung and leader Kim Jong-il regarded the people as my God and served the people as their political ideal and devoted their whole life for the people. Korean people extend full glory to Kim Jong-il, who has realized brilliantly the cause of party building of President Kim Il-sung. The revolutionary historic monuments erected in all parts reflect the sacred traces of President Kim Il-sung and leader Kim Jong-il. National seminars and workshops on the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea were held. The speakers highly eulogized the immortal exploits of President Kim Il-sung, the founder of the Workers' Party of Korea, and Kim Jong-il, who had strengthened and developed it into the party of President Kim Il-sung. Marking the 60th Workers' Party of Korea anniversary, Kim Jong-il led in the van the struggle to make the year 2005 the most brilliant year in the history of the Workers' Party of Korea. He visited all parts of the country, giving on-the-spot guidance to make the Korean people more happy on the auspicious October holiday. True to the far-reaching plan of Kim Jong-il, the builders and helpers out in the Pengma-Cholsan Water Channel project completed a water channel of natural stream style within over 2 years. Soldier builders and helpers turned out as one to carry into effect the behests of President Kim Il-sung and lofty intention of leader Kim Jong-il. They built a new power station on the river Taedong and held the inaugural ceremony on the eve of the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea. thanks to the devoted endeavors of the army and people of Korea, loyal to leader Kim Jong-il, the history of creation and transformation is now unfolded in Korea. Photo exhibitions on the 60th Workers' Party of Korea anniversary showed vividly the historic days when the Workers' Party of Korea, led by President Kim Il-sung and leader Kim Jong-il, steered the socialist construction to victory. The National Art Exhibition represented well the imperishable achievements of President Kim Il-sung and leader Kim Jong-il, who led the Korean Revolution to victory through Sun-gun politics. On the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea, the National Book Exhibition was held in grand style. On the auspicious holiday, Kim Jong-il sent precious gifts to kindergartens, wishing the children to blossom their beautiful dreams, emotions and talents from childhood. The stamp exhibition clearly showed the greatness of President Kim Il-sung and leader Kim Jong-il. Kim Jong-il appreciated the performance of the Russian State Academic Internal Affairs Ministry Ensemble, who came to Pyongyang to celebrate the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea. Russian artists extended their greetings of best wishes to leader Kim Jong-il. The ensemble raised the curtain of their performance with the singing of the song of General Kim Il-sung. The repertoire included the male solo and chorus, My Hero Soldiers, the mixed duet and chorus, The Night in the Suburbs of Moscow, the dance suite, Dance of Gorillas, the Korean songs, The General of Korea, My Blessed Life, and I Think Looking at You. The ensemble concluded their performance with the song of General Kim Jong-il. Kim Jong-il sent a basket of flowers to the artists in congratulation of the performance. The performance of the Russian artists inspired the struggle of the Korean people on the eve of the 60th Workers' Party of Korea anniversary. The Korean people are eulogizing the Workers' Party of Korea, which is guiding the destinies of the people responsibly. The celebration meetings of agricultural working people, women's union members and trade union members evince the pledge of the Korean people. Delegates to the celebration functions of the 60th Workers' Party of Korea Foundation anniversary, delegations of the People's Republic of China, the Federation of Russia and other countries and many foreign friends came to Pyongyang. Leader Kim Jong-il received the government delegation of the People's Republic of China headed by Wu Yi, Vice Premier of the Administration Council of the People's Republic of China. He expressed thanks to the gift prepared with utmost care by Vice Premier Wu Yi. He received the oral message of Hu Jintao, General Secretary of the Central Committee of the Communist Party of China and President of the People's Republic of China, and the congratulatory greetings of the leading cadres of the party and government of China, and conveyed his greetings to them. Konstantin Borisovich Bulikovsky, Presidential Envoy to the Federal Region of the Far East Federation of Russia, was received by leader Kim Jong-il. He conveyed a gift he prepared to leader Kim Jong-il. The president of the Russian Far East State University, who came to Pyongyang together with the Presidential Envoy, conferred the honorary doctorate of laurels on leader Kim Jong-il, who has made distinguished contributions to peace and progress of human civilization. On occasion, the presidential envoy conveyed a personal letter of Russian President Vladimir Vladimirovich Putin to leader Kim Jong-il. Kim Jong-il expressed his thanks to this and conversed with him in a warm and friendly atmosphere. Leader Kim Jong-il received Megawati Soekarnoputri, former President of the Republic of Indonesia and General Chairman of the Fighting Democratic Party of Indonesia. The General Chairman conveyed to him the greetings of congratulation and her gift on the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea. Leader Kim Jong-il warmly welcomed her courier visit and conversed with her in a warm and friendly atmosphere. On October 9th, on the eve of the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea, the inaugural ceremony of the Taeyeon Friendship Glass Factory was held in grand style. Kim Jong-il participated in the ceremony. The whole assemblage conveyed warm greetings to leader Kim Jong-il, who performed immortal exploits to the development of the relations of the traditional DPRK Sino-friendship. The inaugural ceremony began with the playing of the national anthems of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea and the People's Republic of China. Park Bong-ju, the DPRK Prime Minister, made a speech of inauguration. He said that the Taeyeon Friendship Glass Factory is the symbol of the DPRK Sino-friendship, which is ever developing generation after generation. A congratulatory speech was made by Chinese Vice Premier Wu Yi. She said that the factory is a new crystallization of the Sino-DPRK friendly and cooperative relations in the new century, and warmly congratulated inauguration of the factory. The Taeyeon Friendship Glass Factory is associated with the lofty intention and prudent guidance of the leaders of the two countries. Leader Kim Jong-il looked around the modernly built factory together with Chinese guests. He met the officials, technicians and builders of the Yohua Glass Group Company and highly appreciated their merit. Leader Kim Jong-il expressed deep thanks to the party and government of China for providing the DPRK with a modern glass factory gratis. The delegates to the 60th Workers' Party of Korea anniversary celebration functions visited historic Mangyongdae, the birthplace of President Kim Il-sung. Foreign friends expressed their admiration for President Kim Il-sung, who was born at a humble house and made great contributions for Korea and the world. Visitors to the monument to party founding highly praised the monument as a symbol of the single-hearted unity of the Workers' Party of Korea, and recollected the devoted endeavors of Kim Jong-il, who has led the Workers' Party of Korea to victory. Visitors to the Party Foundation Museum keenly felt again the glorious history of the Workers' Party of Korea. The Kim Il-sung이야 Kim Jong-il이야 exhibition was held in Pyongyang, the capital of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. On display in the exhibition hall were over 20,000 flowers blossomed with utmost care by the army and people of Korea, overseas compatriots and foreign friends. Foreign friends could hardly repress their admiration at the gracefulness of the flowers. On the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea, the Diplomatic Corps, the Economic and Trade Counselors Corps, and the Military Attachés Corps in Pyongyang sent baskets of flowers and congratulatory messages to leader Kim Jong-il. Flower baskets and congratulatory messages were sent to him by political parties, heads of party and state, political party leaders, party delegations, and many personages and friends. Gifts came to him from political parties and delegations of various countries, international organizations, cultural and friendship organizations, figures of various strata, and those who have connections with the anti-Japanese revolutionary struggle. All the gifts are permeated with boundless reverence and praises for Kim Jong-il, who has safeguarded socialist Korea and made imperishable contributions to peace and security of mankind and the cause of making the world independent. On the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea, publications of many countries issued extra numbers and carried special write-ups and commemoration articles. The publications said that the 60 years history of the Workers' Party of Korea is the history of the revolutionary activities of great President Kim Il-sung and respected leader Kim Jong-il, and highly praised the immortal exploits of the Workers' Party of Korea, which has carved out a new history of Korea under the uplifted banner of the Juche idea. The National Report Meeting to celebrate the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea was held with splendor in presence of Kim Jong-il, General Secretary of the Workers' Party of Korea, Chairman of the National Defense Commission of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, and the Supreme Commander of the Korean People's Army. The meeting began with the playing of the DPRK national anthem. Kim Myung-nam, member of the Political Bureau of the Central Committee of the Workers' Party of Korea and chairman of the Presidium of the Supreme People's Assembly of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, made the celebration report.
동지들, 조선 인민이 위대한 수령 김일성 동지의 영도 밑에 자기의 혁명적 전위 부대를 가지고 새 사회 건설과 새 생활 창조의 길에 들어선 때로부터
The report meeting summed up with pride that the Workers' Party of Korea founded by President Kim Il-sung is demonstrating its might as the party leading the Sungun Revolution under the guidance of leader Kim Jong-il. The glorious history and immortal exploits of the Workers' Party of Korea will shine as the eternal treasure and the banner of perpetual victory. The meeting ended with the playing of International. To celebrate the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea, the mass gymnastic display and art performance Ari Rang, the Kim Il-sung Prize laureate, was given in presence of Kim Jong-il. All the spectators burst forth cheers of hurrah, looking up to Kim Jong-il, who had successfully steered the Workers' Party of Korea for over 40 years. The army and people of Korea extended the warmest greetings to Kim Jong-il, who performed imperishable exploits in the building and activities of the Workers' Party of Korea by taking over the idea and cause of President Kim Il-sung through the Sungun revolutionary leadership. curtain of the mass gymnastic display and art performance was raised amid the playing of the song Arirang, which is reminiscent of the historic course traversed by the Korean nation. The performance confirms that Korea, full of sorrows, has turned into a socialist land of happiness. Before liberation, the Korean people sang the song Arirang sorrowfully, leaving their homeland to find a way to life as a stateless nation. The lodestar of Mount Baekdul appeared on the nocturnal sky of Korea, which was President Kim Il-sung upholding the torchlight of Juche. The rays of the star shined over the whole land of the country brilliantly. President Kim Il-sung started a revolution based on comradeship and carved out a history full of victory, uniting the Korean people as one. The glorious Democratic People's Republic of Korea was set up by President Kim Il-sung in the liberated Korea. President Kim Il-sung devoted his whole life for the country and people, undergoing all hardships and trials. Leader Kim Jong-il continued without let-up his field guidance traveling a long way of Sungun. He has been true to the great cause of President Kim Il-sung. Thanks to the refined Sungun politics of Kim Jong-il, rosy future is in store for Korea. The children are studying to their heart's content in Korea. Their future is bright indeed. leader Kim Jong-il is unfolding a new history based on the power of Sun Gun. Under his superb guidance, great changes are now brought about in Korea. He is always on the road of field guidance with a mind to show the proud reality of today to President Kim Il-sung. Peasant music and dancing is now at its height, showing their readiness to follow the far-reaching plan and intention of Kim Jong-il. To achieve more rapidly the goal of building a great, prosperous, powerful nation is the strong will of the Korean people in the year of Sun Gun. The Korean people will work incessant miracles in building a great, prosperous and powerful socialist nation by hastening the general march forward for Sun Gun Revolution. The heroic Korean People's Army is the army strong in ideas and conviction and armed with the invincible spirit of safeguarding their leader. It is the great pride of the Workers' Party of Korea and the Korean people that they have the strong army firmly united around leader Kim Jong-il. Superb and breathtaking sceneries are now born by the Sun Gun politics of Kim Jong-il in the land of Korea. Rivers and mountains and the land of Korea are getting more beautiful under the guidance of Kim Jong-il. Ringing out there are the sweet songs at all times. To believe in and follow leader Kim Jong-il is the unshakable conviction of the Korean people. The Democratic People's Republic of Korea, the country where the army and people are united firmly around leader Kim Jong-il, will prosper forever as a great power. Korea's reunification, the earnest desire of the Korean people, will be achieved surely under the wing of leader Kim Jong-il. Korean people who once had to sing the song Arirang with sorrow are now singing the song Arirang of prosperity. They will surely build a new world independent and peaceful in firm unity with the world progressive. Gymnastic display and art performance to celebrate the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea Foundation Arirang was held in the presence of leader Kim Jong-il. It demonstrated the strong conviction and will of the Korean people to brighten the imperishable achievements made by President Kim Il-sung and leader Kim Jong-il for the cause of revolution and build a great, prosperous, powerful nation in this land, surely. The army and people of Korea are extending the greatest glory to Kim Jong-il, General Secretary of the Workers' Party of Korea, Chairman of the National Defense Commission of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, and the Supreme Commander of the Korean People's Army. Sun Memorial Palace, where President Kim Il-sung, the founder of the Workers' Party of Korea and the father of Socialist Korea, lies in state. On the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea, cadres of party, army and state visited the Kumsusan Memorial Palace and paid a tribute to President Kim Il-sung, the eternal leader of the Korean people. foreign friends also paid tribute with reverence to President Kim Il-sung, who made a great contribution to the cause of independence of mankind. Officers and men of the Korean People's Army and people are visiting the statue of President Kim Il-sung with loyal pledge to build surely a strong, prosperous and powerful socialist nation in Korea, true to his behest. Progressive mankind are eulogizing the immortal exploits of President Kim Il-sung for the cause of making the world independent. The army and people paying tribute to anti-Japanese revolutionary martyrs. Bouquets and flowers are presented to the bust of the anti-Japanese heroine Kim Il-sung. On every auspicious national holiday, the Workers' Party of Korea remembers the patriotic martyrs who made devoted service to the party and the leader and to the fatherland and the people. The precious fighting spirit of the heroes produced during the Korean War will be everlasting in the hearts of the Korean people. On October the 10th, the parade in celebration of the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea was held in grand style. Kim Jong-il, General Secretary of the Workers' Party of Korea, Chairman of the National Defense Commission of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, and the Supreme Commander of the Korean People's Army, mounted the rostrum of Kim Il-sung Square. All the participants extended the greatest glory to Kim Jong-il, who has achieved imperishable exploits in building revolutionary armed forces of the Workers' Party of Korea through the superb and seasoned leadership. Seoul, Minister of the Ministry of the People's Armed Forces and Vice Marshal made a speech.
조선인민군 육해공군 장병들과 인민경비대 장병들, 노농조기대원들과 붉은 청년군의 대원들, 평양 시민 여러분, 동지들과 벗들, 오늘 우리는 위대한 당의 영감 밑에.
He said that to hold a grand parade on the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea is an important occasion to brighten more brightly the immortal exploits of President Kim Il-sung and leader Kim Jong-il in the building of the Workers' Party of Korea and Revolutionary Armed Forces, and demonstrate the might of Sungun Korea to the world.
Kim Il-sung 동지의 혁명 사상 만세! 위대한 영도자 김정일 동지 만세! 영광스러운 조선노동당 창건 예순돌 만세!
준비검열을 받기 위하여 정렬하였습니다. 평양시 위수사령관 상장 전진순.
동지들 안녕하십니까?
존경하!
조선노동당 창건 예순돌을 축하합니다. 동지들 안녕하십니까?
존경하!
조선노동당 창건 예순돌을 축하합니다.
존경하!
조선노동당 총비서, 조선민주주의인민공화국 국방위원회 위원장, 조선인민군 최고사령관 동지, 열병부대들은 조선노동당 창건 예순돌 경축 열병식을 시작하겠습니다. 인민무력부장, 조선인민군 자수 김일철!
Amid the overflowing of the feelings of boundless reverence for President Kim Il-sung, who founded the Revolutionary Party of Juche and Revolutionary Armed Forces for the first time in 5,000-year-long history of the nation and led them to victory, the flag of his patriot entered the square. the moment when the army and people of Korea are celebrating the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea, their hearts are filled with an irresistible yearning for President Kim Il-sung. The ranks of Kim Il-sung Military University started their march. Looking up to Kim Jong-il, the brilliant successor to President Kim Il-sung and his revolutionary cause. Determination to complete the Korean Revolution based on the armed forces. Kim Jong-il is leading the Sungun Revolution to victory. The Korean People's Army has been trained into an invincible army, and the army is strong in ideas and conviction under the wing of Kim Jong-il, who is possessed of Juche-motivated military idea, outstanding commanding art, unparalleled courage and iron will. Ranks of paraders of military universities and schools of all levels are marching now. They have all grown more with the passage of 6 years of the Workers' Party of Korea history. Ranks of women political officers are marching, filled with irresistible yearning for anti-Japanese heroine Kim Jong-suk, who devoted her all to the cause of founding party, state and army, together with President Kim Il-sung in the days of nation building. Zongil advanced the original idea that the army is the pillar propping up the party, and the Revolutionary Party should rely on armed forces, and has conducted unremitting activities to cement the military position of the Workers' Party of Korea into an invincible fortress. Under the guidance of the great brilliant commander of Sun-gun, the heroic Korean People's Army has grown into the vanguard of the Sun-gun revolution and the main force of the country, full of the spirit of safeguarding their leader, disregarding death and defending the country. Strong ranks of the Korean People's Army are loyal to their leader and party, unconditional in carrying out the order of the Supreme Commander, and highly efficient in organization and discipline. Every military flags of the units full of feet are associated with the iron will to win only victory as in the wartime. Korean nation, once forced into the destiny of a stateless people for lack of armed forces, has now become a dignified independent people under the leadership of the great brilliant commander of Sun-gun. All ranks of paraders are filled with the great honor of the defender of the country and the creator of the happiness of the people, who are performing feats in defending the country and at the sites of socialist construction. the ranks of the People's Security Forces advancing in fine array, with a fiery resolve to defend the party and the revolution and the gains of socialism and the security of the people. The worker peasant Red Guards are full of pride that they are upholding the Sengun politics of the Workers' Party of Korea with a rifle in one hand and a hammer and a sickle in the other. Enemy dares to invade the land of Korea even an inch, the Revolutionary Armed Forces of Korea, where the whole country has been turned into an impregnable fortress and the whole people have been equipped with arms, will smite aggressors mercilessly. Now, the ranks of the Red Young Guards are marching forward with a firm resolve to prepare themselves to be the bombs to defend a leader defying death. The ranks of the successors of the Korean Revolution are now passing, extending warm greetings to leader Kim Jong-il. The parade to celebrate the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea marked the grandest historic occasion, which demonstrated to the whole world the imperishable revolutionary exploits performed by President Kim Il-sung and leader Kim Jong-il in the building of party and army. Kim Jong-il, General Secretary of the Workers' Party of Korea, the Chairman of the National Defense Commission of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea and Supreme Commander of the Korean People's Army, is in the van to defend socialism and build a great, prosperous, powerful nation by steering the party and revolutionary armed forces to the road of victory and glory, true to the intention and course of President Kim Il-sung. thanks to Kim Jong-il, the Workers' Party of Korea will brighten forever as the party of President Kim Il-sung. And the achievements made by President Kim Il-sung for the Revolutionary Armed Forces of Juche will be everlasting in the history of the revolutionary struggle. Kim Jong-il posed for a souvenir picture with the delegates to the celebration of the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea. The delegates render the greatest glory and heartfelt thanks to Kim Jong-il, who has led the Workers' Party of Korea to victory, unfolding the sacred history of succession in the brilliant chronicle of the Korean Revolution. Kim Jong-il congratulated warmly the delegates, who have devoted themselves to the strengthening and development of the Workers' Party of Korea. He expressed expectations and belief that the delegates will fulfill creditably in the future too, the honorable mission and duty as vanguards of the Workers' Party of Korea. All the delegates are full of a firm resolve to complete brilliantly the cause of the Workers' Party of Korea under the ever-victorious banner of Sun Gun, united strongly around leader Kim Jong-il. On the 60th birthday of the Workers' Party of Korea, working people of all walks of life throughout the country unfolded a sea of dancing, overwhelmed with emotions and joy. Famous mountains and scenic spots discovered and arranged by Kim Jong-il on his long way for Sun Gun politics. People are filled with boundless joy and happiness. Blessed with outstanding leaders and the distinguished party, the Korean people are enjoying heartfelt happiness. They wore the splendid soiree and grand torchlight parade at Kim Il-sung Square on the 60th anniversary of the glorious Workers' Party of Korea. Young people and students are dancing, happy and proud of their success in the building of a great, prosperous, powerful nation. Kim Jong-il, General Secretary of the Workers' Party of Korea and Chairman of the National Defense Commission of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, came onto the rostrum of the... Kim Jong-il has shown lofty love and trust to the young people of Korea so that they could succeed to the generation of the Sungun Revolution invariably. The grand torchlight parade of young Bengals began with the flag of the Kim Il-sung Socialist Youth League decorated with the image of President Kim Il-sung in the van. Youth and students marched forward through the square, filled with ardent yearning for President Kim Il-sung, who performed great feats in the long years of the Korean Revolution. Korean people have leader Kim Jong-il in high esteem, who had strengthened and developed the Workers' Party of Korea as the party of President Kim Il-sung forever. This is the fortune and glory of Korea. Thanks to Kim Jong-il, the 60-year-long history of the Workers' Party of Korea is now shining more brightly. Youth and students are in high spirit with firm resolve to inherit the traditions of the victorious Korean Revolution, which has advanced with a single-minded unity based on revolutionary comradeship. Unbreakable conviction now prevails over the square, the conviction to glorify the Workers' Party of Korea infinitely with the power of Sungun and the single-hearted unity, with leader Kim Jong-il in the leadership of the party and revolution.
Thank you.
60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea was the Great Political Festival, which highly displayed the power of the single-hearted unity of Korea and demonstrated the indomitable spirit of Sungun Korea, which wins victory after victory in reliance on the matchless military forces. Only victory and glory are in store for the Workers' Party of Korea, which is advancing vigorously toward a great and beautiful morrow, infinitely brightening the immortal achievements of President Kim Il-sung and upholding the brilliant commander of Sungun, Kim Jong-il, in high reverence. Long live the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea!